Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Marlborough, Massachusetts, to Navin Arena, as the Hopkinton Hillers varsity ice hockey team takes on Holliston. And it has been a very good start for the Hopkinton Hillers, 2-0 on the season, as they grabbed a couple of big victories. Tom Nappy here on the call for this one against TVL nemesis, the Holliston Panthers, as they get ready for the national anthem. To start off the season, the Hopkinton Hillers back on Saturday, December 10th, beat Dover Sherbourne 3-1, and then beat Medfield 3-1. And we had that game for you on December 14th, which was a Wednesday, right here on HCAM. And right now they're going to go to the national anthem. So let's take a listen in to Navin Arena here on HCAM. There you can hear the student section. It is certainly a packed student section tonight, and they are ready for this TVL battle. All right, so they had some technical difficulties with the national anthem, but they all stood in peace to support their country in silence. So let's take a look at the starters. We'll start off with the Holliston Panthers, and they are going with number 6 right defenseman Tom Ringy, the center captain Jack Larsh wearing number 7, left winger James Franco wearing number 8, number 11 Kyle McDevitt, he's also a captain, and the right winger number 15 David Sandcombe, captain, left defenseman, and the goalie is Adam Campersall, and a captain for the Holliston Panthers. As for the Hopkinton Hillers, in net it is Dylan O'Leary. He's done a great job this season. And then you have Connor Delaney, defenseman, wearing number 20. He's a junior. Number 5, Everett Rolfe, a senior defenseman for the Hillers. And then you have number 9, Jack Sloan, a sophomore forward. He'll get the start at left wing. Number 7, the center, Hunter Temple. He's a junior. And number 15, the right winger, Steve Simos, a sophomore forward for the Hillers, as we are set for the faceoff. And we are underway here from Navin Arena. The Hopkinton Hillers control it off the faceoff, looking for their third win of the season against this young but tough Holliston team. As they go around the net, looking up ice towards the blue line, a pass down by Connor Delaney. And Holliston takes it over, coming up the near side. Holliston working right to left across your TV set as James Franco comes up. We'll get the icing whistle. And the Hillers will get it back in Holliston territory. Well, it's been a good start to the season so far for Hopkinton. A 3-1 win against Dover Sherbourne and a 3-1 win against Medfield. A very good all-around hockey team for the Hillers, one of the best in the TVL. And we are certainly looking forward to a great season here on HCAM, as now in the neutral zone are the Hillers, passed down by Lindquist. Around the net. But this Holliston team, they are a tough, physical team, and they are not going to let this one go easy, that's for sure. As that one, a slap in from the blue line, that's a goal. How about that? Early on, 14:04 left, we get our first goal. That was J.H. Vokey, assisted by Owen Delaney and Matt Lindquist. A quick goal for the Hillers makes it 1-0. As they will face off once again, Nick Temple in the center circle for the Hillers. That one just came out of nowhere. A beauty of a shot from the blue line. Went to the right of the goaltender. Can't ask for any better than that. And we actually have a pretty big turnout here. I feel like the student section starting to catch on more and more about what this Hillers team is capable of, and they're here to support them today. They're right in front of us, so You're going to feel the camera shake a bit. We apologize, but we have a pumped up student section and a pretty full arena here in Marlborough as we'll get a face-off now in the Hillers defensive zone off the icing. Holliston is going to have their troubles here today. They've struggled offensively. Coming in up the middle, the shot. Loose puck, and it's knocked in. How about that? 24 seconds later, it is knocked in by Tommy Hamblett off the J.H. Volke assist. Pretty impressive. Wow. Excuse me, Hunter Temple with that goal. Hunter Temple, number 7, got the last touch of it and knocked it in. Off the J.H. Volke and Tommy Hamblett touches. 2-0 Hillers. 2 goals within 24 seconds. Beauty of an opportunity taken by Hunter Temple. Look out for the junior this season. Hillers controlling from the right circle. The shot, that's saved. Spencer Coveney on that one. Good save by the goalkeeper, Dylan O'Leary. 13:14 left to go, 2-0 Hillers. I'll tell you what though, it's 2 early goals, but this Holliston team, they're no joke. You can't take your foot off the gas. The Hillers are going to have to keep marching on and keep going because these Panthers aren't going to give in as Nick Temple faces off in the left circle in the Hillers offensive zone. They'll be going against James Cruz, who just hopped into the game on the Holliston second line. Over towards the blue line. Holliston takes it over. And towards the wall was Alex Nay. We'll get a whistle there. These are two physical teams as well. I'm expecting a good amount of penalties today. Face off in the neutral zone. Nick Temple for the Hillers. Another one slapped beyond that line for the call. Holliston's going to have to be quicker getting down the ice. You really need to put the pressure on the Hillers if you want to try to beat them. They are just too good on both sides of the puck, too good of a defensive team, and too good of a scoring team to tinker around with. You're certainly going to have to put the pressure on. Now behind the net, coming around, looking towards that blue line, pass up. There's a shot off the end boards. From the right of the blue line, Will Pickens. Now behind the net, there's Tommy Hamblett. Hillers trying to establish control in this first period. Already with a 2-0 lead, but the Holliston defense is ready to create more of a game here. They gave up 2 quick goals, but they're typically not known for that. A pretty sound defensive team. So we get a whistle there. Take a look more at this Holliston team as well. Pretty good, well-rounded squad. Face off in the left circle in the Holliston defensive zone. Hiller's big opportunity here. 12:08 and counting left to go. Good pass down into the zone towards Hunter Temple. Hunter Temple, look out for the junior. He is one of those guys you want to get the puck to. Great shooter. Great one-timer shooter as well. Panthers moving into Hiller's defensive territory. Around the net, it's Connor Delaney. Off the boards, on the near side. Taking it down, Jack Sloan, the sophomore. We get a whistle as he crosses too soon. A couple of Hillers forwards going across too soon. Actually, we're gonna get a timeout here for a couple substitutions from both sides. And these are two fast-paced teams, both of them going to play this game quickly. Face off in the neutral zone. Hillers, they have many returning players from their tremendous playoff run last season, which they went all the way to the sectional semifinals. They are looking to get back to that point even further. A lot of great returning players, and this Hopkinton program is becoming more and more of one of the best hockey programs in the state. Pass up now towards the blue line. Back and forth possessions in these last couple minutes. Good pass down by Matt Lindquist, the junior. Holliston now in control, coming around the end boards. Out in front in the slot, a good save. Nice save by the goaltender for the Hillers, Tim McGrath. And he's really done a tremendous job in net this season. Then you got Dylan O'Leary coming up right behind him, and he's expected to be great too. He's gotten some good experience at the varsity level. And supposedly has a good amount of skill, so I don't think the Hillers program is going anywhere for a while. 10-16 and counting left to go in the first period. Towards the blue line now, pass out in front, into the slot. Deflected by a defender, now out in front, in the right circle. Around the net. Holliston just trying to clear it out of their zone. They don't want to let this Hopkinton first line get off a number of good shots. They know how good they are. Out in front is Holliston trying to take control here. We'll get the whistle there as Danny Rudowitz tries to pass across ice. A couple substitutions for both teams. And it's been amazing these last 3 or 4 years to watch this Hillers program grow and just develop their talent. J.H. Folke is going to spend some time into the penalty box. And Holliston will have the power play. 5-on-4 minus the goalkeeper. Hillers play physical, they're not afraid, and they are not afraid to face these power plays. Back into the defensive zone goes Holliston. Big hit on the near side as Steven Simos got a nice piece of Danny Rudowitz. Holliston trying to establish control. It's Jack Wilkie with it. An assistant captain. Holliston, one of the few teams that actually has an assistant captain. Jack Wilkie listed as the only one. Get the whistle there. Holliston is one of those programs as well that's certainly on the uprise. They are developing talent, and they are expected to be good over the next few years. Big faceoff here in the neutral zone. Matt Lindquist in it for the Hillers. Holliston in control. Pass across the far side by Tom Ringel. Holliston up the ice. Trying to get some kind of shooting going on here. And they were looking for the shot in the slot there. Ended up around the net. Now in the slot, deflected by a defender. High slot, and we get a whistle as Tommy Ringel ready to let it loose. We got a couple players offsides for Holliston. Holliston plays aggressive, sometimes too aggressive. You got to stay on sides, and we're going to get a penalty as well. Cam D. Cristofaro heading into the box. Hillers on the power play. Can they make it 3 goals before the end of the first half? That would certainly be very good for the Hillers. Already up 2-0. 17 seconds left on the Holliston power play. Minute 30 now on the Hillers power play. So Hillers going to have the minute 23 advantage. Nope, bad math there. Minute 13 advantage. Top of the circle, Pickens. Pass down over towards Temple. Holliston trying to take it back over. Here we go. Into the Hillers zone. Shot from the left circle. Good save. Nice job by Tim McGrath. Coming down on the left side. Out in front is Lindquist. Some hard hitting going on in the Hiller's offensive zone. Back in the neutral zone, Pickens down the end boards. Up top towards the line. There it is, the left circle towards J.H. Vokey, and look up for him. He is a hot shot. Already has the goal in this one. He scored the first goal. Assisted by Owen Delaney and Mal Lindquist. There's a tough goal shot from the right side. Hiller still in control. Over towards the far side, Pickens. Holliston trying to take it over. Back and forth momentum since the Hillers scored two quick goals. There's a shot there from Steven Simos. Good save by the goalkeeper, Adam Campersell, the captain. And he is going to be put to work tonight. These Hillers forwards just so good. They are going to get a lot of shots off. Down the near side, Everett Rolfe. Hard check into the boards. 6:55 and counting, left to go. Coming in from the right circle, the backhanded pass. Over towards Hunter Temple. Get a whistle there. Face off on the left circle. A lot of momentum changes in the past few minutes. Alex Nea now behind the net. Good pass down by Everett Rolfe. Whistle there. This one in favor of Holliston. These are two teams that aren't afraid to beat up on each other. Also with a big opportunity here. Around the net is Nea. On the front, good deflection by the defender. Towards the boards, Goggin. Actually it's pronounced Gone, Jackson Gone. Look out for him, good shooter for Holliston. On the right circle out in front, deflected by the defender, Connor Delaney. Breakaway now for the Hillers. Can they take advantage of it down the ice? Jack Sloan on the right circle, shot deflected. Good defense work by Holliston. James Cruz with it now, coming up the ice. Hillers fans pretty pumped up. They know Hopkinton dominating the majority of this first period, possession-wise and shooting-wise. It's been pretty impressive. Wow. Face off on the right circle. Taking it down for Holliston. David Socom, the captain, leaves it behind him into the right circle. Hillers get it back. Deflection by the goalkeeper, Tim McGrath. Out in front, good save by McGrath. It was Jack Larsh, the captain, with the backhand. Game saver right there for the Hillers, keeping the momentum fully in their favor throughout the first period. Now face off on the right circle, Matt Lindquist taking it for the Hillers. Hopkinton needs to keep their foot on the gas. This Holliston team not going away. They're a good shooting team, and they're not a bad team. Despite being down 2-0, they're going to stay in this game. In the neutral zone, good battle here as Larsh trying to take over. Shot from the right circle, wide to the right, and then to the left. It'll be shot out towards the end board on the far side. Behind the net now. Pass out by James Franco. Top of the left circle, Hillers take it back. 4:26 and counting left to go. We'll get the whistle for icing. And Holliston penalty, how about that? These two teams, they're physical. Expect this all game long. You're gonna see a lot of penalties tonight. David Sandcombe, the captain, hitting the box. Minute 30 for the Hillers. Big, big opportunity. Take control of the game now. Don't let Holliston set around. Jack Sloan in the right circle. Pass up top. Hillers looking for their third goal. Good shot from the right side, deflected by the goalkeeper, Campersall. Dug into the end boards on the near side bend. Nicely played by Everett Rolfe, keeping in Hopkinton control. There's Jack Sloan. Pass out in front, looking towards the slot. Deflected by a defender. Now towards the top of the right circle, Simos. Over towards the slot. Nearly a good shot there. Well played by the Holliston defenders, but they need to get the puck out of their zone. Hillers have controlled the tempo of this game. Get the whistle there. 3:37 left, 42 seconds left on the power play for the Hillers. 2-0 lead. But look at this. We've got a penalty against Hopkinton. Jack Sloan will take a seat. So Holliston will have the advantage. Tough physical hockey these two teams are playing. That's what you got to expect in any Hopkinton-Holliston game. Football, basketball, hockey. Gotta love the TVL. One of the best crowds we've seen so far this season as well. Second home game for the Hillers, but a great crowd. And one of the better crowds in last season as well. Get a little glimpse of the student section out in front. Just in front of us, Matt Lindquist down the near side boards out in front, deflected by the defender. And that's icing. Ten left, 2-0 Hillers. A couple players in the box, one from each side. Holliston has the advantage after that 15 seconds is up for the Hillers penalty. Face off on the right circle, shot from the top of the circle, wide of the left. It was Will Pickens. Well, you think about the first game at home the Hillers had, and they just dominated that one. They've got to keep their heads up this year. Can't expect that all game long against every TVL team. A lot of talent on this team. One of the most important things is keeping your foot on the gas. Holliston trying to control it now. On the near side for Holliston, Jack Larsh, the captain. Pinned over at the boards is Tim Ringle. Good match here. Ringle going up against, I believe that's Sloan. Out in front, here comes Holliston. Stolen away. Beauty of a steal by Will Abbott. Holliston gets it back. I have to say, though, it is tough to tell. Sometimes, Husu and Hopkinton, they got the jersey tucked in to that pad in the back, and it covers up part of the number. Makes it very difficult for us broadcasters. So if I'm wrong on any of these players, I apologize in advance. That is the majority of the reason is, if you're watching right now, it is tough to see that full number, but we'll try our best. Personally, I think they should outlaw the jersey being tucked in like that. But that's just me as a biased broadcaster. Coming down the near side, Everett Rolfe. Pass there by Covety. Towards the end board, Delaney. Battled by defenders, trying to get around. 1:33 and counting left to go, out in front. This one is going across back into Hopkinton territory. Rolfe will take it down, pass around the end board, swings around the net. Holliston has a good body check there. Now in the neutral zone, Rolf. Rolf says it back towards the net. Hiller's looking for an opportunity out in front. Over in the slot now. Now towards the edge of the net, controlled by Jack Sloan. Sloan leaves it out in front of the slot, the shot! And that's a goal! Hopkinton goes up 3-0. Spencer Coveney. I believe that was Coveney. It was either Coveney or Pickens. Yeah, look like Coveney from here. I'm giving that one to Coveney. Yes, it is. We're confirming it. It was the senior Spencer Coveney. Typically a defenseman, getting a good shot on it there, putting the Hillers up 3-0. With about 30 seconds left to go in the first period. 47 seconds left to go. Checking the official sheet here as we got the word up from the booth, and sometimes they get things wrong just like we do. Towards the blue line on the left side, swing around the boards. Hiller is in control, up 3-0 in this first period, 25 seconds of counting. Good back pass by Saporosius. Look out for Drew Saporosius. Good defenseman, freshman, going to be a big player on this team for a long time to come. Well, that's going to do it for the first period. Everything swinging in the way of the Hopkinton Hillers. What a great performance it was. A 3-0 lead as we head into the second period. But the key is keep your foot on the gas. Don't let Holliston back in the game. We'll see if Hopkinton can do that. Up 3-0 heading to the second here on HCAN.
Have you ever considered texting and driving? If so, you should know the consequences. If caught texting and driving for the first time, you could get an $100 fine plus your license taken away for 60 days. The consequences only get worse the more you get caught. Even if you don't get caught, there could be serious effects. You could get into a car accident and hurt yourself or someone else. Texting and driving is a very dangerous combination, so stop before this happens to you.
We are just about set for the second period. The Hopkinton Hillers leading Holliston 3-0. What a great first period that was. Officially, they gave the first goal to J.H. Vokey, 14:04 into it. Second goal, they changed it from Tommy Hamlet to Hunter Temple, 13:40 into it. And then Will Pickens with 31 seconds into it. Pretty impressive by the Hillers in that first period. I had Spencer Coveney for the third goal, so I don't know. They might have been wrong. Look, like Coveney got the last touch on that, but either way, either got an assist or a goal. Holliston needs to do some work to get back into the game in this second period. It's around the net now, it's Lindquist. Top of the circle, good shot there. Hillers largely in control to start off the second period. Well, one of the problems with Hopkinton in the past, they get these big leads, they take their foot off the gas, so let's see if they do that in this one. They need to keep their foot on the gas. This Holliston team, despite being down 3-0, they're no joke. Pretty good goalkeeper and Campersall, some good forwards, and they have some pretty good shooters, so they're going to have to keep aware in this one as far as the Hillers. And it's amazing how much this Hopkinton hockey program has risen up over the past few seasons. They've really just done a terrific job at developing it. So here we go, Hillers trying to get back into Holliston territory, out in front, and just wide to the right is Simos. Good shot attempt there. Head coach Chris McPherson has done a tremendous job with this program, assisted by Scott O'Connor and George Jenkins. Holliston led by head coach Dan Gary. Greg Balowitz and Connor DePoth. And we get a whistle there along the end boards. I'll tell you, I've done a few of these Hillers hockey games. Not a whole lot, and I'm going to be doing a good amount of them this season, which is my honor. I love doing these games. But it is cold in this arena. It's cold outside, but maybe even a little colder in this arena. Of course, a beautiful facility here at Navin Arena. Definitely worth checking out a game. Some good hockey takes place on this ice. And it's a very well-maintained arena. Towards the near side, Matt Corbett. Now Connor DeCristofaro. Pass back to Rudowitz. It's going to be interesting to see what Holliston tries to do here to try to get some shots on net. These Hillers defensemen have played a great game so far. Towards the blue line is Wilkie. Over towards the far side, Wilkie chasing it down. Wilkie catches up with it, back ice. Pass towards the near side. Hillers making a couple substitutions. DeCristofaro on the right side, the shot wide to the left. Chasing it down, McDevitt, he's a captain as well, out in front. And nicely done by the goalkeeper, McGrath. Well, Holliston winning the possession battle in the second period. And they are still on the power play from the first period as well. Big opportunity here. 26 seconds left on that power play. Around the net, Tom Ringel. Pass out to Naya. Down their side, right to the circle. What a shot! What a good save by McGrath. DeCristofaro going for the shot. Dangerous situations here. Face off in the right circle. They whistle there as they went behind the net. James Cruz. And that is a Hillers penalty. Physical game, both these teams not afraid to lay down the hits. Jay Tvokey heading to the box. And I believe that was because he threw an elbow. Thought I saw an elbow from the corner of my eye there. It's tough to spot these penalties from up here, but these two teams laid in those shots, trying to get away with it. And I don't blame them because you know what, that's hockey. And they are playing this in a classy way. There's no fist brawls or any of that, but they will lay in those elbows. They'll give those little taps, and they're not afraid to head the box. Out in front now, and a good save by McGrath. Around the net is Larsh. Leaves it towards the slot. Back to Larsh. Blue line. Top of the circle, and a glove save by McGrath. Puck so loose, and that's a goal! Holliston getting on the board. That was Cooper DeCristofaro. Oh wait, no, they're gonna wave it off. That goal is waved off. DeCristofaro was in the crease. No goal, Holliston. 3-0 remains the score. Good call by the official. I thought DeCristofaro was in the crease. Great call. And Holliston was convinced they had that goal. Score remains 3-0. Top of the circle, pass down, around the net. Around the boards. Near side, Di Cristofaro. Miller's trying to take back over. Around the boards is Ringel for Holliston. Tied up with Sloan. Coming down now, Cruz. Into the corner, Cruz trying to dig it out. Left it out for the slot, but only Hiller's there. Coming up ice, Simos. Into the slot. Towards the end of the net, hard check by Ringel. Simos still in control. Good pass, top of the left circle, shot! Glove save! Will Pickens on the shot, Camprasol on the save. Camprasol doing a nice job in net, especially this period. Struggling in the first. Probably should have had a couple of those goals saved. But these Hillers overwhelmed him. So many shot opportunities, but Holliston doing a good job controlling it in the second period. Can they get back into the game? That's the big question. They certainly have not established control of the puck just yet. Near side, McDevitt. Hard check into the wall. And Coveney taking a check as well. Into the circle, there's a shot there. Backhander by, I believe, Abbott. Near side, Everett Rolfe looking up for the turnover. Around the net, it is Larsh. Good back pass by Soperano. Neutral zone, Larsh. Holliston needs to overwhelm Hopkinton. They need to get into their zone. Here they go, making that rush. Backhander in the slot, and that is a goal for Holliston. Just what they needed. Danny Rudowicz, number 12, coming up with the backhander on the one-timer pass. 3-1 Hopkinton, 9:01 left. An impressive set there for Holliston. Can they get back into this game? They're certainly trying. Well, Hiller's let loose a little bit. Holliston comes up big. Time to put your foot back down on the gas. Get aggressive. Keep the puck in their zone. Make Camprasol work. Face off in the left circle. Top of the circle, pass over to the far side along the boards, a shot wide to the right. Behind the net. Hillers aren't shooting that well either in this second period. First period they shot really well. But they are not shooting well in this period. They've had a lot of opportunities, but they need to shoot better. Along the boards. Here we go, Holliston trying to establish control. 2-on-1 on the near side. Around the net now. Pass up the boards. Backhander! Good save by Camprasol. Off the pads there. Holliston needs to clear it out. There they go. Up the ice. Round the net. In the right circle, looking for the backhander. Denied. Holliston taking it back down. It's Naya. There's a whistle. Couple substitutions by both teams. Face off in the neutral zone. For those of you just joining us, you're watching Hopkinton Hillers Boys Varsity Hockey on HKM. Tom Nappy on the call. Hopkinton leading Holliston 3-1. Our production team is myself and Mike Terosian handling all the editing, most of the camera work. We look forward to bringing you Hopkinton Hillers Varsity Hockey all season long. If you'd like to order a DVD, give the HKM Studios a call as well. Provide any game you want. On the near side, Fitzgerald. Good hit there. Diving down to the slot, Nye for Holliston. Top of the blue line, Rudowich. Hit the whistle there. This has been a fun back and forth battle. Hillers took advantage of many great opportunities in the first period. Holliston trying to get into it now, but it's really been a good back and forth game. Left circle out in front. Hillers have certainly won the possession battle so far, without a doubt. They have been the more dominant team in this game. Round the net out in front, and there's a good save. Glove save by McGrath, backhander in the slot. And that was a close call there. That was Larsh with the backhander for Holliston. Face off on the right circle. Clear the zone, Hopkinton. On the blue line, around the boards. Good body checking going on. There you go, in the left slot. And that was a miscommunication. Left circle pass to the left slot, and that was Will Abbott simply not ready for it. Rough, rough, rough. Along the near side. There's a shot from the left circle wide to the right. That was by Lindquist. Round the net. Good body check up along the boards. If you want to beat the Hillers team, you have to out-physical them. You have to out-body check them. You can't be afraid. You have to rush right in there. And that's what Holliston's doing in the second period. It was a great period by the Holliston Panthers. First period, they were soft. They were letting Hopkinton do whatever they wanted. This period, they are sticking up to the challenge, and they are not afraid. 5:29 left to go in the second. Face off on the right circle. In the neutral zone. Around the net. Looking for the pass out in front. Holliston gets the turnover. Good steal. I believe that was Jackson gone with the steal. Down the near side. Farrell in the slot. From the right circle. And that ended up around the net by Rudowitz. Look at that, between the legs there. There's a shot from the right side. Good save by Campersall. Nice puck movement by Temple. We get a whistle in the neutral zone. And a timeout call as well. Both of these teams gonna talk things over, make some substitutions. What a great battle it's been. A lot of fun. This second period, though, is a little nerve-wracking if you're the Hillers. You're up 3-1, but Holliston is starting to get in on that puck battle. Steven Simo's heading to the penalty box. Big opportunity here for Holliston. Can they take advantage of it? In the face-off circle, Jack Larsh. And for the Hillers, it's going to be number 21, Owen Delaney, the junior. top of the left circle towards the blue line. Pass down top of the right circle. Shot to the left, and that's it! Goal, Holliston, 3-2. Number 20, Cooper DeCristofaro getting the initial shot. Jack Larsh knocks it in. And also on the assist, I believe it was Jack Willits for Holliston. Pretty impressive. 3-2 is the score. Scoreboard yet to change. What a great shot there by Larsh, and an awesome opportunity by DeCristofaro exploited. That was perfection. It was to the left of the net. McGrath just barely got a piece of it, and then it was knocked in. I believe it was knocked in, or it was the last touch effort. I don't even know if the goaltender McGrath got a piece of that. But 3-2, Holliston right back into this game. 4:06 and counting left to go. Up the boards, tracked down by Sandcombe. We'll get a whistle. A couple substitutions being made by each team, and you have to imagine Coach McPherson cannot be happy. Cannot be happy with the way this team's playing in the second period. They are not playing Hopkinton Killers hockey. They are better than this. Holliston should not be let back into this game. They have completely taken their foot off the gas pedal. Around the end boards. I'm sure they'll get back into it, though. They know this one's not over, and they're going to get a good shouting at after the second period. No doubt about that. Center circle pass down by Ringel. Hard hit into the boards. Towards the corner. Left out into the right circle. It's Kyle McDevitt and Spencer Coveney meeting up. Hard hit into the corner now. Good job by McDevitt keeping possession. Killers now getting the turnover. 3:06 and counting left to go. Hopkinton needs to get it out of their zone. With this amount of talent on the Hopkinton ice for the Hillers, it is very rare you're going to see them get dominated like this in their own zone. Holliston's good, but they are not Hopkinton good. Pass out in front end of the slot around the net. But they will beat Hopkinton if they don't start putting their foot on the gas, no doubt about that. Because they are not a bad team. Good battle along the corner. And this Holliston team, the thing I like about them most, they're physical, very physical. They're not afraid. They know they don't have the talent, but they know they can get the win if they are more physical than the Hillers squad. That one locked up by the goalkeeper, Campersall. We'll get a faceoff in the left circle. Here we go. Miller's looking for the advantage, and that shot a little bit high from Jay Jvoki. Still in play. Right circle, left out in the open left side. Good pass by Will Abbott. Around the net it goes. Holliston trying to rush up ice. 1:54 and counting left to go, around the net. Hillers take it back. Oh, left circle. And off the goalkeeper's pass and then in. Will Pickens! Assisted by Jack Sloan. And we're getting the official word saying Jack Sloan. Will Pickens had the goal. 3-0 Hillers Scratch that. Three. Two Hillers. Four two-hillers. There we go. There's my math skills coming into effect. Four two-hillers. They led 3-0 after the first. Holliston closed in. It was 3-2. Four two-hillers. Will Pickens getting the job done with a minute and 13 left in the second period. Pretty impressive. Matt Lindquist and Zach Horgan on the assist. Officially, as we get the official word down from the scorekeeper. Well, that was an impressive goal for the Hillers. You need that. Kind of ruins Holliston's hopes a little bit. Still a two-point game. You need to maintain possession. Shot from top of the right circle. That is off the goaltender's pad. Still alive around the net. Out in front in the slot. Nicely played by Sloan getting the shot off. Good save by Campersole. So second period, 4-2. Well-needed goal for the Hillers. Holliston scores two goals within 5 minutes of each other. Danny Rodowitz puts it in at 9:01 left. Jack LaRocque at 4:30 left. And then Will Pickens, 1:13 left in the second period for the Hillers. Pretty impressive. Top of the left circle, there's a shot wide to the right. Good battle along the corner. Get a whistle here. Face off in the right circle for the Hillers, it's Matt Lindquist. Matt Lindquist up against Jack Larsh. Good shot there from the blue line on the right side by Larsh, wrapped up by the goalkeeper, Tim McGrath. I have to say, I have all the respect in the world for the longtime announcer of many Hopkinton Hillers sports, Mike Preet. Announcing hockey through this netting is not easy at all. And Mike Preet did a wonderful job throughout his years with H-Camp. Certainly will be missed, the voice of Hopkinton Hillers sports. But it is my honor to take over, especially for a team like this, the Hillers' tremendous hockey team this year. Look out, it's going to be a fun ride, everybody. There's a shot, and it is around the net. Wide to the left, shot from the left circle. That is to the edge of the net. Top of the circle, and that one is sky high by Everett Rolfe. Good period. Or, you know what, not a good period, but a good few minutes by the Hillers. The first half of the period, that was all Holliston. This half of the period, that's all Hillers. They're doing a nice job. Face off at the left circle, Jack Sloan up in there for the Hillers. I think they realized as soon as Holliston scored that second goal, they realized, you know what, this game's not over. It is not over, we're playing like it's over, we have to get back into it. Good shot there from the left circle, wide to the right, off the goaltender. Nice pickup there by Simos. Had the open shot, took advantage of it. As the clock ticks down, and that is going to do it for the second period. Holliston starts off with a couple of goals in this period to make it 3-2. Then Will Pickens picks it up for the Hillers. 4-2 Hillers after two periods of play. To the third period we go. You're watching Hopkinton Hillers Boys Varsity Hockey on H-Cam.
Do you have what it takes?
Will you make a difference?
Always an adventure.
Police and fire working together.
utilizing the latest technology.
Do you have what it takes?
We are set for the third period of play. A 4-2 lead for the Hopkinton Hillers over the Holliston Panthers. 14:04 left in the first. J.H. Volkey scores 13:40. 34 seconds later, Tommy Hamblett, 6:51 left. Will Pickens scores. And then Holliston puts it in with 9:01 left in the second. Danny Rudowitz, Jack LaRoque with 8, with 4:30 left. Will Pickens with 1:13. And we have ourselves a 4-2 game here at Navin Arena in Marlborough. Tom Nappy on the call, Hopkinton Hillers boys varsity hockey. As we are just underway in the third, we'll see if the Hillers can control it, and that's what they're going to do. They are going to try to keep control of the puck in this third period. And that's what they should do. Just don't let Holliston get it in your zone. You have a good defense. You can trust it. You don't need to be too aggressive shooting. You're up by two. Keep control of the puck. Play with them. Don't let them get to it. Battle along the corner. Towards the blue line, around the end boards. Good body check there. Nice job by Delaney. It's Connor Delaney. High in the net. Ooh, good shot from top of the left circle by Jackson Gunn. Pinned up along the board, Steven Simos for the Hillers. We haven't been keeping track of shots on net, but I have to imagine it's pretty even at this point. The Hillers, they've had the better shots, no doubt. We'll get the whistle there as Delaney crosses the neutral zone. Apologize, having a couple technical difficulties audio-wise. Well, I think we have it straightened out. 12:58 left to go in the third, 4-2 game. Pinned up along the boards. Backhander is deflected by, as Delaney was there, and it was deflected by the goaltender, but Campersol. Nice shot by Delaney. Back and forth third period so far. That one off the post of the net. Around the net it goes. Out in front. Towards the blue line, out of the circle. Well, this Holliston team, they're going to be fun to watch too going forward. Young team. He'll be around for a while. As coming across, Nick Temple. Nick Temple, he is an interesting player. Senior forward, done a great job this year as there's a shot from the right circle from Everett Roth. Love save by Campersol. I'll tell you, we appreciate the job that the stat keeper here is doing at giving us the goals. And we just wish he'd write a little better. My writing's just as bad, but I apologize. His writing's been pretty tough to read tonight, but we think we've gotten the correct goals across. But he has done a great job at keeping up with the action, no doubt about it. And my writing's just as bad, so I can't criticize him too much. Pinned up along the boards. And I'm sure head coach for Holliston, Dan Gary, went into the locker room after the second period. He said, you know what? We have the chance to get back into this game. Don't give up on it. Don't let this Hillers team get you intimidated. We have a chance. It's Tommy Hamblett, the freshman, going to head into the penalty box. I'll tell you what, I like Hamblett. Good physical player. You're going to see him in that penalty box a lot, but he's a great shooter, great forward, and an aggressive player. He's going to be in the starting rotation throughout his whole high school career, especially if he stays in Hopkinton. Hopkinton quickly becoming a hockey powerhouse in the state. They were rated by Mass High School Sports, the number two program this year, behind number one Hanover. And of course, Hanover was the team they lost to last year in the postseason. The Hillers have a lot of returning players, and they are expected to do great things all season long. Around the net, pass out in front at the line. It's White, top of the circle, Larsh. Now over to the right circle, looking towards the slot. Good defense by the Hillers. Connor Delaney, low in the zone, has done a nice job. He comes up in the zone. You see Everett Rolfe replace him. And they are making it very difficult for Holliston to get a shot off. Well played by the Hillers defenseman. Top of the circle. Deflected shot by Will Fitzgerald. And there is a glove save as Larsh lets it loose. McGrath wraps it up. Good job by the Hillers defensively, but I'll tell you what, 10-17 left. You have to get it out of your zone. In the face-off circle, Spencer Abbott for the Hillers, Alex Nye for the Holliston Panthers. Up the ice we go. Around the net, it's Delaney. Into the corner, Lindquist. Buried up there, is trying to scoop it out, Nye. Lindquist gets wrinkled on that opportunity. Around the end boards, Matt Lindquist. Well, this is a long way down the road, but this Hillers team, can they keep up with those tough teams on the Cape? Because they're going to see a lot of them in the postseason. I think this team's going to go far, but it's going to be interesting. Can they keep up with those Cape teams? The Cape teams have a historically good record at just being dominant in MIAA hockey. Left of the net, left out for the slot, loose puck. Slapped along the boards by Temple. 9-12 and counting, left to go. Shot along behind the net. Pass towards the corner. There's a slap shot. Deflected off the pads. Will Pickens on the opportunity. Campersol deflects it away. There's Pickens again. Letting it loose towards the corner. Along the line it goes, and there's the whistle. That was Steve Simos, sophomore, looking for the shot. Steve Simos, even as a freshman, tremendous player. And that's a good thing about this Hillers squad. They have so many young players that shined last year. They're going to continue to shine all throughout their high school careers. .845 and counting left to go. 4-2, Hillers leading Holliston. Around the net, Sloan leaving it out in front. And it's saved. Temple trying to put it through. Campersol wraps it up. Campersall, despite giving up four goals, has done a great job in net for Holliston. This Holliston defense corps is not working very well. The Hillers have had way too many shots. Campersall has done a lot of great saves and has done tremendous in keeping this game from getting out of hand. Hiller is just playing keep away right now, as they should. You're up by two. Waste some time off that clock. You don't need to be 100% aggressive. You certainly don't want Holliston to have it in your zone, but waste some time off that clock. 8:01 and counting. The defenseman going to pass it around a little bit towards the boards. And right now they're challenging Holliston. They say, hey, try to get a shot off. You can't. The defensemen have complete confidence that they are not going to get beaten. And they have won the battle in the second half of that second period and throughout the beginning stages of this third period. The defense corps has been tremendous for the Hillers. And they are challenging Holliston right now. Along the boards. There's a slap shot in the slot, deflected by the defender. Good body check up against the boards by Jackson Gott. Near side. Coming down, it's Abbott. Here's Connor Delaney. Everolf puts it around the boards. There's a whistle. And I have to tell you, I've only been to a few of these Hopkinton Hillers hockey games, but tonight is definitely one of the biggest crowds I've seen. Good student support tonight. They're right in front of us, which is why you might have seen the bleachers shake a couple times, but they have been great supporting their Hopkinton Hillers hockey team. And this team is too good not to support. Back in those years where they were so-so, they struggled to get wins, they didn't have a whole lot of talent. I could see why the fans weren't coming, but now you have no excuse. If you're a Hopkinton Hillers alum, you have to get here. Or if you're a current student, you just have to get here, especially for this team. This team is very promising. They're going to go far, as that shot is wide left by Pickens. Behind the net now. There's a whistle. Body checking going on up behind the net. Well, these two teams have put on a fun match tonight. It's been a physical game, and there is no doubt in my mind they would love to battle. The official checking up on Adam Campersall right now. He was a little shooken up on that last play. Took a hard shot from the puck right around the waist area. So the official checking up on Campersall, he's okay. He says, I want to stay in the game, ref. Tough kid. Shot from the left side, deflected off of the defender. Well, this Holliston team, it won't surprise me if they make the postseason, that's for sure. Wide to left there is Delaney. Hopkinton, they are expected to go deep into the postseason, so there's no doubt about that. Holliston, they're maybe in, maybe out, but they should be in. I think they have enough talent to be in. Will they go as far as Hopkinton? No. Can they compete with Hopkinton? Probably not. Have they played a good game here tonight? For the talent they have, absolutely. It's been a good game for Holliston. But the Hillers have also been impressive. Good save by McGrath off the pad. Breakaway, right circle. Hard hit into the boards. Sloan was on that break. And in the neutral zone, Rolf skating around, tripped up a little bit, loose puck. Slap shot there, deflected by the defender, out in front. Good pickup by the Hillers, nice job. Tommy Hamblin on the breakaway. Great defense by the Hillers. That could have been a wide open goal for Holliston. Tommy Hamblin, Everett Rolf doing a great job up ice. And Everett Rolf, he is a player that has impressed me many times this season. Great defenseman. Coming across, Nick Temple. There's a whistle. 4:37 left to go. The Hillers holding Holliston to a 2-point deficit. 4-2. Well, actually, in hockey, 2-goal deficit. Use the correct terminology. Face off in the neutral zone for the Hillers, Nick Temple. Covenant. Down the ice. Off the pad. Tim McGrath has done a wonderful job in net for the Hillers. What a great goaltender. I'll tell you, the Hillers, if they win this game, they'll be 3-0. A lot of that is because of Tim McGrath. And a lot of this Hillers success is going to be because of Tim McGrath. Just a great goaltender. He has saved countless good shots by these Holliston forwards throughout this game. .401 left to go. Nick Temple in the faceoff for the Hillers. Hillers holding the puck, shot from the left side, wide to the right. Top of the right circle, Will Pickens. There's a whistle there. A lot of whistles in this one. Jay Trokey doing a nice job up that left side. This is another player that really impressed me last season. I think he's going to get a lot of playing time this year. He played forward or defenseman. Right now they're using him more or less as a forward. In the slot, backhander, wide to the right. Hillers cleared out quick. Towards the blue line, Volke. Pass down, around the net. Holliston has to do some quick work to get back into this one. Less than 3 minutes now. Hard check there, Cam DeCristofaro. Putting, I believe, was that Griffin Zach into the boards? Did he get into the board, Griffin Zach? Just waiting to get a number there. Nope, number 22, excuse me, is Will Abbott. And he's going to the box. That was his fault, threw an elbow. I thought he was going to go to the box because of that. Thought I saw a little elbow there, wasn't quite sure. He's a physical player, Will Abbott. Junior, forward, great player. Not afraid to throw the elbow. That's hockey, though. You just can't do it too much at the high school level. Top of the circle, Jack Wilkie. Pass out into the slot, deflected by the defender. Nice job by the Hillers defensively, and that's what they've done. They've let a guy, a defensive guy, hang out in the slot and just tap it out, and it's worked for them all game long. Holliston is not crowding the slot. That's why they're not getting the shots off they want in this period. They need to overwhelm the Hillers, and they're not doing it. They're putting one guy there to shoot it, and the one guy for the Hillers defensively hanging back in the slot, easily able to deflect it. 2:05 left and counting. Holliston in their desperate moments, trailing 4-2. Left circle slapped away by Connor Delaney. In the corner now. Slap shot there wide to the right by Cam DeCristofaro. Around the net is Jack Larsh. The right of the circle, in the circle, and that is off the pads. McGrath in front, deflected by the defender. Good job by McGrath, saving the two-goal lead. What a job McGrath has done in this game. He has played unbelievable in net. I'll tell you what, I'm putting Tim McGrath as player of the game, no doubt. The Hillers hold on to this, which I think they will. Tim McGrath's player of the game. We have a timeout, 1:12 left to go in the game. We'll finish it off coming up next on HCAM. Off the timeout, 1:12 left to go. We are ready. Matt Lindquist in the faceoff for the Hillers. 1 minute and 12 seconds and counting left to go for the Hillers, who improved to 3-0. Now below a minute. Hold on to the puck, don't let it go. Top of the right circle, out in front, McGrath. Gloves it up. Seconds and counting. Empty net for Holliston. Seven seconds left. We're going to get a whistle. Good goaltender combination for the Hillers. Tim McGrath, Dylan O'Leary. They've done a great job. Penalty for the Hillers, 7 seconds left. A little too late for Holliston. That's gonna do it. Hopkinton Hillers improved to 3-0. A 4-2 victory over the Holliston Panthers. Quite an impressive victory. That will wrap it up here from Navin Arena in Marlborough. This has been a presentation of Hopkinton Hillers Boys Varsity Hockey on HCAM. I'm Tom Nappy. Thanks for watching, everybody.